This question I think you get quite a bit, but let's go to it because people do seem confused. Brian wants to know, what does it mean when someone says that they're being gaslit?
Yes, commentators and hosts and so on will say, oh, they're gaslighting us. And because we know what it means, we think everyone knows what it means. If someone is gaslighting you, they want you to stop thinking what you're thinking on the grounds that you're mad and you cannot trust the evidence of your own senses. You thought Biden lost the debate? No. You don't trust what you saw or heard. So that's what it is. They're trying to convince you can't trust your own mind.
Right.
Comes from a movie, 1948 movie, in which Charles Boyer was a murderer and he was trying to persuade his young wife, played by Ingrid Bergman, that she was mad. She was going off ahead. So when someone is trying to change your mind by saying you can't trust your brain, it's unreliable.
Sorry, with the movie, what's the connection with gas?
Oh, because when he committed a murder, it's in the era of gaslighting in homes, the gas dimmed when he was killing someone.
Right.
You've got to see the movie sometime. Great old movie.
I'm going to go home straight after the program and watch it. All right, Dawn wants to know where the term whippersnapper originated. And is it a term of endearment? Like if you called me a young whippersnapper, which of course you would, Kel,
yes.
are you complimenting me or are you having me on?
Nowadays I would be. Because it's become a term of fondness. We apply it to children. But in
right.
the 1600s, when it first appeared, it meant a diminutive, insignificant, unimportant person. The implication was it was someone who needed the whip snapped over them to get them going. So it was a bit of an offensive term when it first was born, but that was the 1600s. And it's become softer over the years.
All right, last one, and we've only got a few moments left, but the phrase, there's more than one way to skin a cat.
It means there's more than one way to do whatever the task is, and it's part of a group of phrases. There were lots of versions of it. There's more ways to kill a cat than with feeding it cream. There were lots of these things. They were born in America, early 1800s. We don't know why, and I don't even know if it's true that there's more than one way to skin a cat. I just know that this group of phrases were born in America at that time to say there are other ways of doing it.
It makes me wonder if there was ever a time where skinning cats was common, Kel.
And why were cats always the villains?
Well, I'm a dog person, so I totally understand the sentiment behind it. I appreciate you joining me tonight.